Colorado mountain that stands tall in the sun, and nobody knows what this black mountain done. A train crew of seven met their fate, they say, when they went up on this mountain on the 10th day of May. That mountain was so high and the wind, it got cold, and the snow started falling, so the story was told. The people down there in the valley knew the train would never come, but the brave soul that laid on the throttle was a man that was destined to run. Them big wheels turned and the rails caught fire, that's a message they sent down the telegraph wire. That mountain path was narrow and the track was steep, and the snow lay on the rails about 4 feet deep. A wind was a-howling and the night was cold, and a 45 grade made that train hard to hold. The people down there in the valley knew the train would never come, but the brave soul that laid on the throttle was a man that was destined to run. Them big wheels pounded the rails so hard that the mountain peaks rumbled and the canyon walls jarred. That canyon wall was rugged and the sign said slow was 4,000 feet to that rough ground below. A snowslide started and the track gave way, and that engineer's down in that canyon to stay. The people down there in the valley knew the train would never come, but the brave soul that laid on the throttle was a man that was destined to run. A light struck the mountain and the land felt the shame, and the people in the valley gave a mountain his name. That big mountain turned to the color of steel, and its engineer mountain now his legend is real. That big mountain stopped the train from making that run, but the way the story ended, I think the engineer won.